You are filling in for Chris Riva on a great day.
Great for two reasons. One, I love beef. And two, we had portobello mushroom burgers for dinner. Now, they were good last night, but I'm all about the beef. They left me asking, where's the beef? And you've answered that question this morning.
Yes, because the question was, what's for dinner? Yeah. So today, Shawn Menard from Chop Steakhouse has an awesome idea, and it is peppery.
Yeah, we're going to do a three peppercorn encrusted New York steak. We're going to get started here. We have a 14-ounce New York steak that we dry aged and hand cut at the restaurant. We're just going to season that up. Whoops. A little kosher salt,
mm-hmm.
Both sides.
But kosher salt's great for grilling, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, and then we're going to get our peppercorn medley on here. We're using three different kinds of peppercorns.
Okay, we've got the recipe up for you as you're doing that.
Okay, you really want to press them in there.
Okay.
And get it going into a hot pan. We're going to mark it off on both sides. While that's going, we're going to make our sauce. So we've got some butter melting here in the pan. I'm going to add in some chopped shallots. Just let those caramelize a little bit. Okay, to that, we're going to add some brandy. Watch out for the flame.
Whoa.
There it is.
See, there it is.
Wood flame, right?
Okay. While that's going,
I don't need that hair on my arm.
We're going to add in a little Dijon mustard.
Boy, this is just a handful of ingredients, too.
Yeah. Very simple.
Are you going to cook the whole thing here in the pan?
No. Actually, what you're going to do is after you flip it over, you're going to want to take that and put it into a 400-degree oven for about 7 to 10 minutes. Okay. We're going to add in some veal stock.
Okay. And I suppose even if you wanted to skip the sauce and just keep it super simple, you could just do it here in the pan and finish it up in the oven.
Exactly,
make it really easy.
You know, you could finish it with a really nice high-quality olive oil and maybe a little balsamic vinegar. It's really good.
Are you digging in already?
Fascinating.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So flip that guy over. It's going to go into the oven. You're going to turn it one time while it's in the oven.
Okay.
Okay? And we have the finished product over here. I'm just going to bring...
Well, we had it.
We had it,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, wait. I missed out on the sauce.
Going to bring the sauce right here.
Wow.
Go right over the top like that.
Oh, that's nice. And the twice-baked potato with it. That's great. You know what's nice about this is that sometimes after grilling over the weekend, you don't really feel like getting the grill back out again.
No, you don't.
You know what I mean? So
exactly.
Sometimes it's just kind of nice to do things in the house.
And if you don't want to heat the house up with the oven, you can put a little lid on your pan and you're ready to go.
And it's good to go. Mm-hmm. Hey, that's awesome.